missiles now.
Not today, scum. Escort one to Overlord. Spring the trap.
We have you now.
Target locked.
They're running for their lives.
This one is mine. Target destroyed.
Another kill, and another step closer to victory. Let's regroup.
Commander.
Malgus.
Your assistance with the 38th Fleet's operations has been exemplary. But I am now recalling them for a special assignment. Empress Asena invites you to join a special meeting of the Dark Council aboard Vikan Space Dock. We will discuss the details of the operation there. I am told the Council looks forward to hearing your voice among them once more.
The last time I joined a meeting of the Dark Council, I killed one of them.
All the more reason to respect you. We await your arrival. Malgus out.
The Meridian Complex, a state-of-the-art Republic shipyard. It nears completion on the planet Corellia. My spies report that it can produce ships faster than any of our shipyards and at half the energy cost.
That hardly seems possible.
Based on the technical readouts Zarian has acquired, I assure you it is entirely possible. Perhaps it is even a conservative estimate.
Malgus, Krovos, your plan for destroying this facility?
By securing our frontline positions and withdrawing all but the most crucial warships, we have formed an assault armada of unrivaled size and power.
Under our command, this mighty fleet will burn the Republic's new shipyard to ash and destroy any hope of victory that might remain among their people.
Will the Alliance be joining this assault on Corellia?
Yes, but we have another objective to complete first.
We have gathered enough fuel ships to carry our fleet to Corellia without stopping. Our enemies are in no such position. The Republic will scramble reinforcements from all corners of the galaxy. Wherever they stop to resupply, we must disable or destroy them.
We have already identified one likely refueling point for the Republic ships. The planet Onderon.
Conveniently, I am already engaged in operations to undermine Republic control of that planet. However, my forces are meager, to say the least. But with the aid of the Alliance and its commander, I am confident that I can successfully delay any Republic reinforcements that pass by.
Your predecessor wasn't the most focused ally. I hope you do better.
I'm confident that we'll work well together.
Excellent. Keep your spies in place, Zarian. We must know everything about the shipyard and its defenses. Anathel, Varon. Be ready to provide any assistance that Malgus or Krovos should request. This operation is the Empire's top priority.
Understood.
My logistical networks are entirely at their disposal, Empress.
Then this meeting is complete.
Commander, fancy meeting you here.
Major Andri, are you joining the mission on Onderon?
Nah, I pulled Darth Aran's operation this time. We're headed for some mined-out rock called Mekshar, but word is we might catch up groundside on Corellia.
I've missed you, Synthosis. How have you been?
Same old, same old. Fly here, blow up that, sneak into this, kill everyone. You know the drill. To tell the truth, once you've fought with the best, everything else just seems a bit dull. Know what I mean?
Major Anri, I need to speak with the Commander. Alone.
Of course, my lord. Please excuse me. Until next time, Commander.
As Sith, it is our nature to seek our own advancement. The Dark Council may have changed, but that drive remains. Victory on Corellia benefits us all. It advances us all. Should Lord Savik or any other Council member forget their priorities in my absence, the Empress grants you leave to remind them.
They will not forget their duty to the Empire on my watch.
Good. Lord Savik awaits you. Farewell, Commander.
Come in, Lana. Our objective is Onderon. Take everyone we can spare. You'll be briefed on arrival.
Understood. We'll depart for Onderon at once.
Welcome to Onderon. This is the Royal Hunting Lodge of King Petrith, the current ruler of the planet.
Onderon has been a Republic planet for centuries. Not that Petrith cares, he just wants to sell his planet's resources to anyone willing to pay.
Which is where the Empire comes in.
Exactly. Petrith's greed makes him an easy target for Savik to manipulate. But his nobles aren't playing along.
Petrith may have the throne, but the nobles have control of the capital city and day-to-day operations. If they learn of his Imperial ties, he could be deposed.
And what of the Republic fleet we're meant to destroy?
Still gathering in orbit. They're preparing for refueling and resupply operations.
Savik doesn't have the resources to attack the fleet head-on, so we're pretty sure she's going to trick Petrith into doing it for her.
Forget Savik. Call in our ships and order them to destroy the fleet. Simple.
Commodore Pardax strongly advises against it. The Republic fleet is sizable. We would incur significant losses and couldn't guarantee total destruction of the enemy.
Ready to get started?
I was surprised to find you absent upon my return from the Senate, my king. Do you expect to visit the capital soon?
I will return when it suits me.
We have matters to discuss. When do you think it would suit you to return?
You overstep, Senator. It is your job to share my decisions with the Republic, not to question them. Do not bother me again! The nobles' meddling was bad enough without Nebet to stir them up further. This is intolerable! Am I not king? Do I not rule this world?
They clearly don't respect your power, dear king. And to send the senator back here. Perhaps the Republic believes you need more supervision. But you need not concern yourself. I have brought a powerful ally to ensure nothing comes of your enemy's plans. Allow me to introduce the Alliance Commander.
I rule my own planet too. We have much in common.
Well, I'm sure yours is nice, too. Welcome. Nebet's provocations have utterly drained me. A hearty meal will aid in my recovery. Do enjoy your visit.
As you can see, the king all but eats from my hand. He is the key to our victory here. Onderon's capital is equipped with powerful defensive cannons that could easily destroy the Republic fleet in orbit. The cannons cannot be operated remotely, but if we spur the king into a civil war against his nobles, the distraction will suffice. We will infiltrate the capital amid the chaos of battle, seize control of the guns, and eradicate the Republic fleet before they even realize they're in danger.
Sounds like a plan. What's our next step?
Petrov already suspects that his nobles are moving against him. We need to push that paranoia further. Through intermediaries, I have hired a band of mercenaries to infiltrate the hunting lodge and assassinate the king. Fortunately, you will swoop in to defeat these deadly attackers just in time. You will save the king, earn his trust, and push him further from his nobles all at once.
Simple enough. When do they arrive?
If my calculations are accurate, the mercenaries will arrive any moment now. I'll be happy to guide you to them over the comm. Good luck.
Oh! I take it the ruthless assassins have been dealt with. Now that the area has been secured, we can exit the safe room.
This is an outrage! They think they can kill me? Me! I am the King of Onderon!
Once they realized your strength, Nebet and her Republic conspirators knew they could no longer hope to control you. Killing you was their only option.
But I'm the king!
Yes. I have deployed my droids to defend the premises. I assure you that you're now quite safe.
Good, good, excellent. Well done, yes.
My king, what of your cousins? They're still at the ancient proving grounds.
And? What do they have to do with any of this?
It's possible they're in danger too, good king. If your enemies are attacking you, they could also target your family. But the commander who valiantly saved your life can certainly rescue your cousins as well.
Good then, get on with it. My blaster, I need my blaster. Oh, where did I put it?
His gullibility exceeds even my greatest estimates. We have given him fear. Now, we must give him anger. Find the king's cousins at the ancient proving ground. Kill them. Then spread evidence that Nebet is to blame. Petrif will demand retribution, and we'll have our diversion.
I seem to be doing all the work, Sarek. When will you contribute to this mission?
My talents are best devoted to controlling the king and preparing my droids for the eventual assault. The Onderon wilds are treacherous. You should take a guide with knowledge of the terrain. Speed is crucial. The Republic fleet is about to begin refueling, but my plan is unfolding perfectly. Victory will be ours.
Ah, Commander. I believe I've found a pair of local guides we can trust.
Jacaro, C2D4.
Better than they treated us, clearly. We really need this.
What have you been doing since Yavin?
Working for a succession of idiots and cheapskates.
I shall leave you in their capable hands, Commander. Good luck.
Hands. We just need to pick up a few questionably legal items to ensure all goes to plan. Luckily, we've made exactly the right friends here. Right, Jacaro? The delivery should be waiting for us. These blasters were modified to look just like the nobility's, house insignias and all. Rather ornate, too. Do these ID crests look a little flimsy to you? Well, at least Petrov is the only person they have to fool. Now for the data pads. Our slicer friend promised they'll be full of authentic personal correspondences. You pay for quality, Jacaro, and I had a good feeling about him. I'm an excellent judge of character.
Thank you.
Feeling a bit better now? Feeling a bit better now? Feeling a bit better now?
Oh! Not one step closer. Identify yourself.
I don't talk to corpses.
What? I don't understand.
Ugh, I'm tired of all this nonsense. Let's go back to the capital.
Get down! For Onderon! You will not harm my wards!
Is the king.
I know, but I can't kill him yet, so your deaths will have to tide me over.
You'll regret this!
Savik, Petrov's cousins are dead.
Such a tragedy. I'll inform the king they were slain hours ago. Well done. Savik, out.
Commander, good. The king is attempting to rally support for an invasion of the capital. Your efforts were beyond successful. My plan unfolds precisely as scheduled. The king will rejoin us momentarily, having realized he lacks the military support to reclaim his palace. He will ramble about traitors, demand the blood of his enemies, and remind us yet again that he is king. Then, with the simplest prodding, he will realize where to acquire the troops he needs.
You really do have this down to a science, don't you?
I am not a cunning fighter like you. I learned that lesson years ago. So, I have honed alternative skills to secure my victories.
Traitorous! Cowardly! I want them all dead! The Bet, the nobles, my worthless bannermen, the Republic, all of them!
Dear King, surely your allies rallied to your cause.
Some did, and they will receive a king's reward. But far too few. We cannot take the capital with such a small force.
I only wish the Empire could provide more aid in these dark times. No one else on this world has the strength to challenge the nobles and their off-world comrades. It seems impossible to believe.
No. Onderon's strength is not yet lost. There is one group. They've hated the nobles for years. Tried to undermine all relations with off-worlders. I always dismissed them as backward and paranoid, but perhaps they were right all along. About the Republic, that is. They are known as the Untamed. Their leader is a Beast Lord, a Kuru. He's a keeper of Onderon's old ways, but he will not join us easily.
Please, King Petrith. If we cannot supply the troops you so badly need, at least allow us to win this ally for you.
Akuru and his untamed are proud and stubborn. They have no more love for me than the nobles. I'm not sure how you could secure their allegiance.
This Beast Lord might not possess your level of intelligence, but then, who does? I'm sure he can be reasoned with.
Indeed, yes. Even a fool could see the wisdom in joining my cause. I will prepare myself for war. Good fortune to you, friends.
All too easy. The Untamed are Onderon's only other major group. Once they're weakened by joining this attack, they will pose no further threat to Imperial operations.
There is a proper way to seek an audience with them. An old ritual. They love old rituals.
Excellent. And one more thing. I've learned that Akoru's elder brother, Brutan, once trained as a Sith. He died fighting Republic forces on Hoth. The rest of the Untamed aren't aware of Brutan's service. To leave Onderon and serve off-worlders would be abhorrent to them. Perhaps a useful bit of leverage over Akuru.
I'll keep that in mind when I speak to him. Thank you.
Of course. I must finish preparing my own droids for the assault. It is best if any Imperial identifying components are removed. Good luck.
Feeling a bit better now?
The untamed beacons should be nearby. You'll need to light them to gain an audience with Akuru.
Feeling a bit better now?
Beacons are lit, and the ancient rites are observed. I am Akuru, Beast Lord of Onderon. You have shown your respect. Now speak your purpose here.
King Petrov needs your warriors to help him attack the capital.
We have heard of the king's squabbles with his nobles. Nothing on Onderon is hidden from this world's true masters. I'm not surprised that Petrov would seek outside help. His blade has never tasted the blood of his foes. But why should I help a fool against his enemies? I have no love for any of them.
Because I know your brother's secret. I can tell your followers, or you can do what I say.
What? What do you believe you know about my brother?
He trained to become a Sith like me. He died serving off-world masters.
Curse you! Bruton was a hero to us all. I will not see his reputation marred. Untamed, hear me! Rally all warriors! The hour of our revolution is at hand! Bring forth Crashalock! He and all of our beasts shall have a half portion! Let them be fueled for the fight, but still hungry for victory!
Ha! Crashalock! But his beast's name! It's actually a pretty clever pun, if you speak ancient Onderonian at least. I'm honestly impressed.
Petref will learn what real strength is. We will show the galaxy the true power of Onderon.
I'm telling you, an idiot doesn't come up with a pun like that. Or speak a forgotten language. Insane? Perhaps. Xenophobic? Bigoted? Murderous? All fair. But he's not an idiot. Not the bigger idiot, anyway.
Debating relative idiocy, are we?
They can't decide who's more foolish, Petref or Akuru.
Really now?
Onderon, your conquering king returns! After this day, none will question my power!
Excuse me?
He said you're sure to win, oh mighty king.
I am indeed. Our noble forces await us. To war!
Between Petref and Akuru, the capital's security forces should be adequately distracted. While they attack the main gate, my droids will blow open the city wall near a sewer bypass. That will be your entry to the Orbital Defense Cannon's control center. Once you destroy the Republic fleet in orbit, our victory on Corellia will be one step closer.
It's about time. I've had enough of this backward planet.
Backward? Perhaps, but also tantalizing in its possibilities. The local plant and animal life could provide invaluable research data, though capturing a key Republic planet is worthwhile regardless. To that end, once the fleet is dealt with, you should regroup with Petref and his troops. If you aid them in defeating Senator Nibet and her Republic allies, Petref can rule unchallenged as the Empire's puppet. Onderon would be ours.
You think he'll survive long enough to even reach the palace?
With our aid? I have no doubt. I will deploy my droids to clear a path. Good luck, Commander. This will be a day long remembered.
Thank you.
what you can find. Explosive chemicals. Are you certain? I suppose we don't have a choice. Good luck. It worked. Hurry! You must reach the orbital controls inside the palace.
Invaders!
Surrender! It is not too late! Surrender!
Defensive cannons activated. I'm targeting the Republic ships now.
Underon Patrol, this is Captain Person. Hold your fire! I repeat, hold fire! You are attacking friendly vessels!
I say again, Underon Control, you are hitting Allied ships! Cease fire! Cease fire!
We're done here. The Republic ships have been wiped out.
Outstanding. You have exceeded even my most aggressive calculations. Meanwhile, the Republic's chances at victory on Corellia have decreased at least 43%.
Unfortunately, and perhaps unsurprisingly, the King's assault has not been as successful. I believe Petrif and Okoru have breached the palace, but the last of my droids have been destroyed. I have no visibility.
Please, meet them in the throne room. ensure the greatest possible victory for our Empire. Savik out.
Onderon will return to the old ways, the pure ways. Your blood will wash away centuries of desecration.
You don't fight for Onderon. You fight for your own bigoted agenda. You fight, and you lose.
His loss is my gain, Nabet. I've beaten you. I've won. Did you really believe you could steal the throne of the great King Petrif?
Steal your throne? What in blazes are you talking about?
No sense lying now. Your treason is over. I've won.
You fight for the Empire. Petrif, what have you done?
I have secured the prosperity of my planet forever. Now I rule Onderon, not the Republic, and not you!
You're a pawn, Petrif! Don't you see? You've doomed our world!
Don't worry, Senator. You won't live to see it.
Ha ha ha! The throne is mine! Onderon is mine! You, step forward. Your service to my rule shall never be forgotten. The people of Onderon will cheer your heroism for centuries to come.
I have what I came for. I no longer need to tolerate your stupidity.
How dare you! I am the King of Onderon! The King!
I've confirmed it with my own sensors. Total destruction of all Republic ships in orbit.
And without a single Imperial casualty. You have served your Empire well indeed, Savik. Empress Asena will reward your ingenuity and loyalty.
Savik has done an excellent job. Her plan was well conceived and flawlessly executed.
Without you, this would not have been possible. I am fortunate to have worked alongside you. With Petrif as our puppet ruler, Onderon's resources will help ensure the Empire's future.
Resources are not our most urgent concern. Savik, you will depart for Corellia at once.
Yes, Lord Malgus.
Another fleet of Republic reinforcements is docking at Medshar, as Darth Vauron predicted. That will be your next target. Ensure another victory, and the Republic will have no hope of stopping us.
So,
What's our next stop?
Set course for Mekshar.
Ah, we know it well. A mined-out asteroid converted into a fueling station. We would love to join you. If you think your alliance has room, of course. Please?
Please?
It's been a pleasure working with you again. Welcome to the Alliance.
Wonderful.
I have a shuttle prepped and ready, shall we?
Miss me?
Commander, we captured this one slaughtering Alliance soldiers on Iokath. She nearly killed me before we subdued her.
Hello, Master.
I'll take it from here, Lana.
Please, be careful. I don't like what I sense from her.
So that's the famous Lana Beniko. She's a weakling. I would have liked watching her die.
Harm a single hair on Lana's head, and I will personally ensure your destruction.
Yes. You'd like to strike me down, wouldn't you? When you disappeared, I pretended to feel nothing, but I was devastated. You were the only thing I cared about. It took everything I had to accept your death and move on. And then 6 years later, I turn on the HoloNet and see you. Alive. Seated on a throne of power.
And now you crave that power for yourself.
You still don't understand. You abandoned me! I loved you and you let me believe you were dead. The empire we wanted to create together. You built it without me. And the worst part is, I still love you, even after you cast me aside. I guess I'm weaker than I thought.
I'm surprised, Jaysa. Where's the promising Sith who grew stronger through her emotions?
Her heart was broken. I just wanted to hurt you like you hurt me, so go ahead and punish me, Master. You know I deserve it.
I didn't mean to abandon you. Join me, and we can start over.
I won't fall for your lies.
Use your power on me. You'll see I'm sincere.
Fine. I sense kinship. And pity. Like you're reaching out to me through the Force. I don't understand. How can you feel this way after what I've done to your people?
We're connected, Jaysa. Nothing will change that. Now come home.
It seems I still have much to learn from you. I'd like to start over, if that's possible. You're not off the hook, you know. We have a lot to discuss, but perhaps the future is looking up. Me now. Nice. Nice.
Commander, welcome to Mekshar, outlaw crossroads of the galaxy. Darth Shah, I'm pleased we finally have an opportunity to work together. I've heard such delicious things about you. I served your old ally, Darth Vauron. He asked that I aid in supervising this operation due to my experience with the galaxy's criminal element. This intriguing specimen is a member of the Brothers, our key allies on the station. They've provided the Empire with quality slave labor for many years.
It is our great honor to take those without value and give them value, to give labor to those without purpose.
Why don't you tell me your plans for Mekshar?
As direct as your reputation. Our goal here is more complex than it might seem. Let's step into the operations center to discuss the details. Wait. There's some... What? Oh!
Oh!
now.
Blazes was that?
I have no idea, but I appreciate the help.
Anytime. It's good to see you again. Lord Shah still in one piece?
Oh, yes. The Force was strong with him. Pity he didn't stand a chance. For a Sith to defy the Empress and attack you during a top-priority mission, you must have done something truly stirring.
He was no match for me, and he knew it. Let's get back to the mission. If he tries again, I'll just kill him.
I'm going to enjoy working with you so much. Shall we?
Ah, old friend. Such a pleasure to see you again after so long. I overheard something of a commotion. Is everything all right?
Someone attempted to kill our dear guest.
An assassination attempt? On you? I'm amazed that there's anyone left in the galaxy who would even try.
I'm not convinced it was an assassin. It felt more like I was being tested.
Really? I shall task some of our people with tracking the assailant down. I would love to learn more. Now then, Shah, let's go over what we've planned.
A Republic fleet key to the defense of Corellia has taken position nearby and intends to purchase fuel from Mekshar in order to continue their journey. It is our task to ensure that this fleet never reaches its destination.
So, we stop them from refueling.
Unfortunately, that wouldn't fulfill our Empress's command.
If the fleet cannot acquire fuel, they'll simply consolidate what fuel they have into their most powerful warships and send them on. We do not have sufficient vessels to prevent this, and we must make every effort to stop the entire fleet.
Then we lure them in and attack while they transfer the fuel.
Just so, old friend.
Major Anri, explain your discovery.
It just so happens that a perfect weapon is built into this rock. All we have to do is take control of it. See, this place used to belong to the Hutts, till their slaves revolted and kicked them out. Now Mekshar's neutral, run by the five biggest crews on the station. Huttbreaker, she led the revolt. Well, she wanted to be sure nobody could show up and steal what she and the other slaves just won. So they put in a failsafe. It fires a pulse that neutralizes all the fuel in Mekshar's tanks, plus whatever's in the fuel lines, and any ships attached. We could even juice the pulse up a bit, make it strong enough to ignite the fuel everywhere but the tanks, fry every ship in the fleet.
Perfect. How do we get started?
The decision of whether to sell fuel to the Republic fleet hasn't been made yet. It depends on a majority vote by the top five crews. It falls to you to persuade them to vote in favor of selling the fuel, to help the Republic walk into our trap.
Fortunately, you have the perfect opportunity to get started. Brother?
Huttbreaker hosts a celebration, an auction of pointless material wealth gained without effort. The five strongest crews are invited.
You join our dear friends at Hutbreaker's auction. Ensure that the crews vote in favor of selling the fuel. And help the Republic slip its head into the noose.
I wasn't sent here to make small talk with criminals. Have one of your lackeys do it.
None of my lackeys are the infamous commander of the Alliance. Your fame makes you more persuasive than any of us could be.
If any other developments occur in the meantime, we will inform you at once.
And watch your back. At least one of these crews is already in the Republic's corner, or the fleet wouldn't have come here in the first place.
Best of luck.